Doctors of Reddit, what are some of your anti-vax parent stories? Not a doctor, but a story I heard stuck with me. The head of pediatrics from a Toronto hospital, I forgot which one, was giving a talk and told a story about how, early in her practice, she had a little boy in for his scheduled vaccines and was answering the nervous mother's questions. The mother planned to go ahead with the vaccines, but had heard lots of anti-vax propaganda, and so she was worried and had lots of questions. While they were talking, but before they administered the vaccines, the poor little kid suffered a grand mal seizure. It was really bad. The kid ended up getting admitted to the hospital and suffered a fairly serious brain injury. It occurred to the pediatrician much later that if that seizure had hit 10 minutes later, or if the appointment had been 10 minutes earlier, nothing would have ever convinced that poor mother that it wasn't the vaccine that caused the seizure. Had a kid come in for generic upper respiratory virus. Asked mom if he was vaccinated, as is routine. She said no. When I asked why not, her response was, well, my boyfriend was vaccinated, and he still got meningitis, so they don't even work. I told her that's the same as saying your friend got bruised by a seatbelt in a car accident, so you don't wear them when you drive. We had a 14-year-old female come in for abdominal pain one time. She weighed 80 pounds, looked sickly. Her mother refused to let her eat anything but a handful of things, nothing with very much protein at all. She literally had a binder full of articles about how horrible vaccines are, all the bad things they put in food these days, etc. She had completely brainwashed this kid, so the kid believed it too. Her labs showed malnutrition, her teeth were horrible. Just a sad case all around. Had a 5 or 6 years old patient who had a super hippie mom. No reason for not vaccinating other than she doesn't want to, despite counseling many times. Kid also had asthma and would consistently come in for exacerbations despite prescribing appropriate controller meds. The amount of exacerbations just didn't make sense. One day, I sent my student to see him first, while I called the pharmacy to see if his meds were received. The student came back saying, I can't get a history from mom. She's literally falling asleep while talking to me. Also, pharmacy said the meds haven't been picked up from the last 3 visits. That was enough for me to call CPS. Mom was on drugs. Living situation deplorable. Last I heard, kid was moved to an aunt who caught him up with age-appropriate vaccines. When I was a med student, I had a parent who wanted to do a backquote delayed vaccination schedule. Basically, it means that you get all the same vaccinations, but you pointlessly and foolishly do it over a longer time period. The mom had read a book promoting this practice that was unfortunately written by an MD. My pediatric attending had zero chill. Is that the book written by doctor? Yes. Well, then you should know that I was in the same medical school class as doctor, but I got much better scores than he did. Not a doctor, but so significant other works with children that have autism. She has one parent that consistently tells her she regrets vaccinating her kid. She then asks questions to MISO about which vaccines are the ones that cause autism, as if it's a big secret. MISO tells her that autism is predetermined before birth and signs just aren't noticeable until around 2 years of age. She still tries to justify her logic with other anti-vax parents' stories from FB. MISO has 2 master's degrees towards this field. It blows my mind how they can still argue with overwhelming facts. I'm not a doctor, but an RN in public health. I recently had a mother call me to ask me if it was a smart idea for her child to get the MMR vaccine. Why was she asking this? She was worried that would make his autism worse. Nearly qualified pharmacist here, so obligatory not a doctor. Our pharmacy offers travel vaccines for people going away to countries with a high likelihood of severe tropical disease. Star parenting goes to the parents who got themselves vaccinated for rabies, but not their 2 primary school age elementary, for non-Brits children. In medical school I saw a kiddo whose parents refused vaccines, and so when they were given a vaccine refusal form to sign, this form essentially said that the parents understood that refusing vaccines was against medical advice, that their kiddo could get sick from all those preventable diseases, and that they wouldn't hold the doctor slash practice liable for any complications that the kiddo may get from said preventable diseases. This mom pulled out a Sharpie and blacked out the part about the doctor not being held liable. The parents thought that we'd be cool with them just changing that form just for them, and they wanted the doctor to be held liable for their moronic choice. Of course this didn't work, and they were told to sign the form or they would be discharged from the practice and have to find another. They refused to sign and were told to leave after given a list of other pediatricians in the area. Med school student here. I was getting my hair cut and I was talking to the barber about how more people should get the new meningitis B vaccine, since I know a person who got meningitis B and almost died. The desk lady went off about how vaccines are dangerous and pretty much every single anti-vax's talking point. I explained the actual facts behind vaccines and said that I'm studying medicine. I think I might know what I'm talking about. And then she went off about professors not knowing what they are talking about and that they just teach what they are told to teach so that we can all be brainwashed into supporting the big pharmaceutical companies. And that my proof were all fabricated by the Medit. Someone told me we made it into YouTube. Not a doctor, but a nurse and a vaccine advocate. Once had a public argument with a friend from long ago. He argued that by not vaccinating his kids and risking terrible side effects and possible autism, he was placing no one else at risk, however acknowledged the potential risk to his kids. After attempting to explain the potential risk to others and him failing to understand, I created an analogy which I still use to this day. Imagine if my kids and your kids get into the same car. Both of your kids don't put on seat belts. Therefore, if there is an accident, there is an increased risk that your kids will die and also harm my children in the process. This seemed to click with him, and he doesn't share his anti-vax propaganda on social media anymore. Not directly related to my being a doctor, but a mutual friend of mine and my wife's is a chiropractor and anti-vaxxer, refused to vaccinate her first two kids. I didn't want her or her kids coming anywhere near our place when we had newborns or kids too, because of the risk her unvaccinated kids placed on my partially vaccinated babies. She got all offended, saying the usual rubbish like, if vaccines work, what do your kids have to fear, and your kids are more risk to mine because they'll be back, quote, shedding viruses, apostrophe. Her third child was born with cystic fibrosis, which makes them very susceptible to all forms of respiratory and airborne infectious diseases. Suddenly the whole hypocritical family is vaccinated against everything. Not a doctor, but I worked at a children's hospital in research, at the time as a coordinator. A bunch of us were sitting in our office space talking about medical care of some sort casually, I think maybe flu vaccines, and one coordinator's cuts in. Well, I don't know if you have seen the recent research, but there are a number of issues with vaccines that make them unsafe. They are highly correlated with autism. The room got quiet because everyone was polite. One person said, "Oh, I heard that, I think," in an effort to not alienate the girl. I responded, "That's not true, because I couldn't not say that." She said, "Yeah, I'll send you the link." I said, "I think I've probably read the study. It's been rescinded." Then it got more awkward. This was probably 2017. I just couldn't believe that in 2017, a person whose job it is to understand research at a hospital with children can fall victim to bad research that has not been supported by any reputable source since probably the 90s. I'll tell a different kind of story. I'm a nurdoc and recently had this interaction with a patient. Adult male comes in with fever. He comes back positive for the flu. "Me, you have the flu. I will write you for a prescription for Tamiflu, patient. Doesn't that cause autism?" This guy couldn't even remember that it was vaccines that reportedly cause autism, and he couldn't remember that it wasn't the flu vaccine. And of course he is wrong about vaccines causing autism. And he is a grown ass adult that thinks he will suddenly be autistic. I'm not a medical doctor, but a mental health therapist, went to do a new client intake, and while asking the mother about the kid's medical history, vaccination records etc., she said he was not vaccinated because vaccines cause autism and she didn't want to risk her son getting it. Then when I went to meet the kid, within 5 seconds of laying eyes on him, I could tell he was autistic. Worst part was that when I told her, she became very upset and started yelling at her husband, saying he must have gotten the kid secretly vaccinated, and then immediately ran out the house and took the kid to the emergency room for testing and just left me and the dad in the living room just kind of staring at each other. Never answered my calls or texts again after that, and I had to get DCF involved. Not a doctor, but my former primary care doctor was a crazy anti-vaxxer. He told me I didn't need the meningitis vaccine, because no one gets it anymore. Freshman year, I woke up in my dorm and couldn't move any of my limbs. My roommate took me to the ER, and I tested positive for it. I ended up staying in the hospital for 3 weeks, and am lucky to be alive. The doctor is thankfully not practicing anymore. When I was a medical student, I had a 5-year-old patient who looked and acted like a 2-year-old failure to thrive. His mother was super weird. She shaved the sides of his head somehow like a marine cut, but kept his back hair long. She refused to vaccinate him, or even feed him certain foods. Her sister and her husband were trying to get custody of the child, because his mother was weird and didn't take care of him properly. I suspect she was paranoid. She would literally fight and call you names if you attempt to suggest to put the kid on a proper hospital diet. She wanted to inspect the food first and make sure he eats only certain things. Long story short, the attending calling county and they took the child away from her. Edit. Thank you for those who pointed out that the haircut is called a mullet cut. Another point to add, he was admitted for a fracture, which was really worrisome in a kid that age. Unfortunately, I don't know what happened to the kid after they took him away, but has definitely better off. Not a doctor, but I'm a brother of the victim. My mom has this belief that vaccines cause mental illness. She forbid us to go to the doctor, and 6 weeks later my sister got sick and died from measles. I'm now as distant from my own mom now. I had a kid come in that was super sick. 3 years old and in septic shock. He had the flu and another compounded viral infection, or maybe pertussis. Heart rate was close to 200, respiratory rate in the 50s, blood pressure in the 70s. Kid was so ducking dry that we could barely get fourths into him, and I almost had to drill an IO. We dumped a ton of fluids into him, started him on vasopressors, and transferred him to the local children's hospital. I had asked the mom if he was vaccinated, and she said no, vaccines have really bad side effects. They'll make you sick. I explained to her that not getting the vaccines had made her kid 10 times sicker than he ever would have been from any mild vaccine reaction. She told me I was a ducking moron, and that I obviously have no clue what I'm talking, and that's the reason her kid was getting transferred. She also told me that recommending she vaccinate her kids was racist. Edit, didn't expect this to blow up, so some clarifications and answers to common questions. CPS was called, and, once again, I was told there would be no investigation. This is their usual response. My wording about it possibly being pertussis was clearly confusing and misleading. I ducked up how I phrased it. Pertussis is indeed bacterial. Made the edit to make it more clear. RN and NP student, not an MD. This was like 2 years ago. I don't remember all the specifics. I didn't follow up with the other hospital about how the kid did. I try not to follow up on patients to keep things compartmentalized.